So welcome to our first lesson in this Form 3 topic, quadratic expressions and equations. In our first lesson, we are going to learn what are perfect squares and imperfect squares. To do that by use of an example. First example, we have a quadratic expression which is x squared plus 2x plus 1. In Form 2, you learned how to factorize. So, we say that for you to factorize a quadratic expression, get two numbers such that when you add them, you get the coefficient of x. When you multiply them, you get the constant. So, remember that. So, in this quadratic expression, our two numbers, that is a plus b, should give us 2, and a multiplied by b should give us 1. So you realize that 1 plus 1 is 2 and 1 times 1 is 1. So we rewrite our quadratic expression like this, x squared plus, instead of now putting 2x, we say it is x plus x, which is the same as 2x plus our constant 1. So once we do that, we factorize what is common here. So there we have x, we are left with x from x squared plus, when you factor out x here, you'll be left with 1. Then plus, here we factor 1. So we have, you'll be left with x plus 1. You realize that this is common to both, so we factor it out, x plus 1, and we'll be left with x plus 1. So we have x plus 1. This, we refer to them as repeated roots, which you can write as x plus 1 into bracket squared. When we have a quadratic expression with the repeated root, we say it is a perfect square. Just like we say, one squared is 1. That's a perfect square. 2 squared is 4. That's a perfect square. 3 squared is 9. It is the same as what we refer to as here. So let's take another quadratic expression and see the difference after the break. So, in our previous example, we found we noted what a perfect square is. In this another example, let's see what we get after we factorize. So we are going to take this quadratic expression, and that is x squared plus x minus 6. So that's another quadratic expression. When we factor this, remember here we have 1x. So we get two numbers such that when you add the two numbers, you should get 1, which is the coefficient of x. When you multiply the two numbers, you should get the constant, which is minus 6. So I'll take 3 and minus 2. 3 minus 2 is equals to 1. 3 times minus 2 is minus 6. So those are the numbers that we need to use. We rewrite our quadratic expression, x plus, instead of now 1x, we have 3x minus 2x minus 6. So that's our quadratic expression after we apply the two numbers. So we have to factor this. We factor out x. We'll be left with x plus 3. Here it's x squared. And here is 3x. So here we'll be left with 3. Put the bracket. Here we have minus 2x and minus 6. So we factor out minus 2, we will be left with x there plus, this will be 3. So note, minus 2 times 2x will give us 2x, minus 2 times 3 will give us minus 6. So we have not changed our expression. So this is common. So we factor out 3, x plus 3, and we will be left with x minus 2. X minus 2. Now, this quadratic expression is not repeated, does not have repeated root. As you can see, we have x plus 3, x minus 2. So it is not a perfect square. hope now you understand the difference between a perfect square and a quadratic expression which that is not perfect. Let's compare the two expressions and see whether we now understand what's a perfect square and a non-perfect square after the break. So we have factorized two quadratic expressions. The first one was x squared plus 2x plus 1. We found it is equals to x plus 1 into bracket squared. So that's what we got after factorization. The other one is x squared plus x minus 6, and we got x plus 3 x minus 2. So you can now see the difference. We cannot be able to combine these two. Therefore, it is not a perfect square. Here we have repeated root, x plus 1. So that's a perfect square. So this is a perfect square. Not a perfect square. Let's do another two examples where the coefficient of x squared is not equals to 1 after the break. So another quadratic expression is an example of this one, 9x squared minus 6 plus 1. So we have 9x squared, we have minus 6x plus 1. So this is a quadratic expression. Let's factor it out and see whether it's a perfect square. When the coefficient of x is not equal to 1, what we do is we multiply the coefficient of x squared multiplied by the constant, which is 1, that and that, so that we get the product. Then we get two numbers, a plus b should give us 6, coefficient of 6, so that is minus 6. And a multiplied by b should give us the product of the coefficient of x squared and the constant, which is 9. So what are these two numbers? I will take minus 3 and minus 3. When you multiply minus 3 times minus 3, you get 9. When you add minus 3 plus minus 3, you get minus 6. So we rewrite our quadratic expression like this. 9x squared minus 3x minus 3x plus 1. We factor out what is common here. It is 3x. Here we'll be left with 3x, and here we'll be left with minus 1. Let's factor out, so because what is it, we want what will be left inside the bracket be the same as what we have here. Let's factor out minus 1, and this will now be 3x minus 1. So we factor out this, so we have 3x minus 1. Here we will be left with 3x minus 1, so we put that under the bracket, inside the bracket, minus 1. And this, because they are the same, we can combine and see that this is equals to 3x minus 1 into bracket squared. As we can see, the roots are repeated. So it is a this expression is, quadratic expression is a perfect square because the roots are repeated. Let's take another one and see whether it is a repeated, it is a perfect square. Another quadratic expression is 2x squared. We can take 2x squared plus x minus 6. So the coefficient of x is not equal to 1. So we multiply 2 multiplied by minus 6, we get minus 12. We get two numbers such that when you multiply the two numbers, you should get minus 6. When you add the two numbers, you should get 1. Here we have 1. So this is 4 and 3, minus 3. 4 times minus 3 is minus 12. 4 plus minus 3 is 1. So we rewrite our expression 2x squared plus 4x minus 3x minus 6. Note here we have no change. 4x minus 3x is the same as x. So we factor out what is common here, which is 2x. We'll be left with x plus 2. Here we factor out minus 3. We'll be left with x plus 2. Note here, what is inside the bracket is the same, so we were able to factorize. We factor out this, so we have x plus 2. And we have, we'll be left with 2x minus 3. We cannot be able to combine this. So this is not a perfect square. Not a perfect and that brings us to the end of our lesson. I'll give you an exercise which you can try on your own and see whether you'll be able to identify perfect squares and non-perfect squares. So welcome to the other lesson, the second lesson, which is in the ViewSasa. You can be able to view our next lesson up to the last lesson in quadratic expressions and equations. So you are all welcome.